Hello, ladies and gents, everything between and without, and welcome back to more Heal the World of Warcraft. On this mini, we have the Motherlode on heroic mode.
It's too far.
And we start off with a shit ton of trash just being pulled. Now, on normal, when not everyone is at the max level and with good gear, even on heroic, if you don't have a good team, then your best chance is to pull small groups. But apparently these guys were extremely versed, and they had good eye level and good skills, and the tank was extremely well, confident in himself, which as you can see was paying off. And so he pulled a whole bunch of crap right at the start. As you can see, we have quite a couple of minions here who really like to annoy by freezing random people. And apparently I unfortunately pulled a couple of thugs there. Yeah, see? And so I had to heal myself a bit. Did I die here? I think I died. No, I actually healed myself. And of course, there are plenty of enemies here who try to target the ground beneath you, so you kind of have to move, or else you will slowly but surely lose health, which is not a very useful state of affairs. So you're going to have to watch your feet, watch your health, watch the other people's health, especially the tank. But again, your DPS are so important. I seem to, and apparently I was seemingly ignoring them, especially the last one, Fantastic, which from the name tells me that he has a fantastic van or something. I don't know. People and names. You could spend a while and try to crack them, but you'd probably be wrong. For example, for Quel'Dronas, it was something very random. You know, we had like Quel'Thalas and Quel'Drone, you know, because he drones on and on with his convoluted stories about when he was, I don't know, the elite paladin, the first one to be, second one to be granted the, you know, the holy power. Because of course, I think in canon, blood elves only got the holy power right before Burning Crusade, if I'm not mistaken. I don't exactly remember the reason why. But of course, Lady Liadrim was probably one of the first ones to get it, because she seems to be the leader of the blood elf paladins. Blood Elf Pally Squad. OP.
Venture Company thanks you for your patronage. Please enjoy your purchase of the Elite Pummeling Package.
And first boss.
Engaged. Commence pummeling.
Coin operated crowd pummeler. He has a few skills. Number one, electrocution, which pulls you back. Number two, bombs, which you can kick at him, thus setting him on fire and giving your DPS a little help, you know. And then I think he are these the only two ones which interest you? It may just be. I'm not seeing any more bombs, so he probably had not reached the stage yet. Ah, see? Foot bomb launcher. He had. As a healer, you have some insta heals which you can use. You can like run around and help your DPSs there. Apparently I got a repeller. Which, did I equip it? I don't think so. It was a shield, right?
I need to get closer.
Okay, now this part, this freaking part. As you can see, again, you have a bunch of minions, but you can dodge a few by going up this small hill here. And also pulling a bunch of crap, which, you know, DPSs have to kill as fast as possible. Remember to use your AoE heals, as I was doing here. Especially because most of your DPSs are melee.
I'm out of range.
That's a very good excuse to use your AoEs, your multi heals. And also at this part, please remember to dodge the bombs because they can be quite annoying and painful. And also the large earthquake or whatever. Oh wow! Holy crap! You see? Those dudes just took out, and I think I was dying too. But yeah, they actually took out one DPS quite easily. I couldn't do anything. This is why it is important for DPSs to also watch their feet, because healers are not... sorry. I promise you it's not Corona. So yeah, healers are not gods. Well, maybe some are. Or at least close to them, but yeah. But at this point I was actually not, as you can clearly see. I'm doing these just to show you guys. I've never actually taken my healer rating. Maybe in the future, I have no idea. Maybe in the next expansion or whatever. But yeah, probably not. Okay, so this next phase involves another small ton of these elementals, and also the second boss, Azeroth. The best thing to do here is to actually pull all of the adds first, or at least part
it's
of them.
Too far away.
So basically, what you need to do is to destroy the apparently these adds are tied to the boss, so you actually have to kill them near the boss, and you have to kill the adds first before you take on the boss, for reasons, of course, for reasons of state. Unfortunately, we were waiting. There we go.
Trespass in my domain.
So for certain business, the Earth Ragers must go. They have to be targeted. As you can see, I was also targeted by an Earth Rager.
The blood of Azeroth flows through you.
Yeah. And Mr. Azeroth here was making himself a pain, also. Not a big one, but you know, a dull pain which you can barely sense. Because your gear is too good. So most of you have to you have to run from the Earth Rangers when they pursue you. And then you have to dodge this big dude's Azeroth's massive AoE abilities, you know. Or shaking, whatever it may be. And yeah, he at some point will begin to remake his Earth Ragers. And of course, as before, you have to kill them first.
The blood of Azeroth flows through you. The wounds must.
The wounds must be mended. Roar. Okay, next stop, you have a short cart ride. Fun stuff. Followed by one of the more painful things to do, aka this zone. The following two, the zones between the last two bosses, I mean before the last two bosses, are just chock full of enemies. And you cannot actually dodge them. So this is filled with goblins and also rats. And And also, something in that group randomly turns people into oozes and confuses them. So if that happens to the healer, then of course, if the others are not paying attention, then they may die, because the healer won't be there to mitigate anything. Some people actually go behind the house to my right. Apparently, we went right through the middle because we were freaking badasses and wanted apparently to slaughter everything in our way. No ninja business for team. What's the healer's name? For team multi-gas, because apparently she was just filled with noble gases and ones which were rather less noble, if you get my drift. Ha 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 ha, fart jokes are still funny, right? Alright, so apparently these testers are quite pissy and annoying, and those alchemists, I think the alchemists are the ones who actually turn you into oozes, because as you know, alchemy is a path to many unnatural powers, like the dark side of the force, for example. Alrighty. But yeah, thankfully, 20 minutes is, I think, pretty fine for the massive level of mobs which you can find in this dungeon. It's pretty okay. And also, maybe try to skip this, because you will be slowed down a second by Tar.
If you want a job done right, use Bega Explosion. Looking for Azerite?
Okay, so she has a few things. First of all, she covers some ground with boiling Gazrat or something, and you have to avoid it. And then she will, I think, fire something towards someone to knock back. Oh no, actually, it's this. Yeah, Azerite Barrage, which again litters the ground with Azerite. And as you can see, if you stand on it, you will burn to death. Propellum Blast.
Propellant in the morning.
Yeah, she really likes her propellant, apparently.
Looking for Azerite? Have a face full.
But the question is, I wonder, does the propellant actually clear out the Azerite from the ground? We haven't tried that.
I should have gotten Azerite.
And of course, the Azerite just magically disappears, and the random pipe just lets out a bit more Azerite just to screw with our heads. But yeah, that's the second to last boss done. Now this part is rather annoying. As you can see, you are bombarded by massive rocket barrages. You have technicians which heal the mechs. You have the mechs themselves. You have other crap around here. You have skyrockets which shoot rockets at you. You have bombs littering the ground, you have mines who just pop out of the ground and start following you if you get close to them. So yeah, this place is quite a mess. I think even the best team would have some problems pulling absolutely everything here. Yeah, see, a mine was targeting me. Apparently it exploded and I got hit a bit. Yeah, see, as I was saying, barrages of rockets. And also knockbacks. Oh god, the knockbacks. It's a painful area to deal with, especially if you're not targeting the correct things. Again, the technicians are the most important here, because they will prolong the fight by constantly repairing the war machines. They have to be taken care of first. Apparently we mercifully stopped. Oh yeah, apparently the tank just decide to randomly pull more stuff. Goody, more work for me. And of course, the orc DPS was just trying to absorb as much damage as humanly possible, because that's the DPS's job, right? That's it, yeah. To freaking die. Apparently my AoE heals were not enough for this situation. So I was constantly targeting now the last DPS, and I think the next to last. Yeah, see, I was kind of switching between them. I was trying to keep everyone alive at this point. Begging that that the fight would just stop, which it did apparently right now. I mean, it had.
Do you bums realize how much property damage you've done?
And Mogul Razdunk. Razdunk. Alright, and now apparently the main dude was explaining the main mechanic of this fight. Which I have to say is quite a good one, and many people just screw it up because they do not pay attention and or do not care. So the main gist, also this is why it was 19 minutes, I think we sit like a minute here waiting, and I was a bit impatient. Because I was making my bat exclaim. I have to say that the tanks who do this thing are just the salt of the earth. They are they're very good people, because they actually care about finishing the mission, well, the dungeon as quickly as possible. Okay, so you have barrages, he has like this machine gun which you can dodge. And then he will become, he has rockets with which he targets certain people, and you have to go out of range, and both the ones not targeted and the one targeted have to go out of range from each other. As you can see, sometimes it's faster to just run into the barrage. Alright. At this point, some dudes spawn. And then some explosives will appear on the ground, which you will see. And of course, you have to dodge the barrages. And then each one of you will be targeted. And you have to get to one of these on time. After the arrow disappears, run, because he will crash into it, and that will damage his shield. And as you can see, that guy was not following orders, unfortunately. After that dude explained to him, he still wasn't getting it. It was extremely unlucky. I think the Demon Hunter was doing the exact same thing, not coming.
Pulverize!
Yeah, so we could have had less time spent here, unfortunately.
Pulverize!
Because the only one who actually did the tactic correctly. Okay. There was another one. I think that was it. I think he was not vulnerable. Yeah, he was. And the rest of the fight moves on exactly as the first half. So, hope you enjoyed this part, and I'll see you next time. Bye!
Should've sprung the ejection.